Sana.
Amen.
I was somewhere in a forum and I was speaking on some matters. I was not preaching, I was speaking on some matters. And after the service, after the talking, a man came to me and said, no, he didn't come to me, he was talking to somebody else. So when this man speaks, you just want to listen to him. And then I wonder, will those people I speak to feel the same? Where are you? Just want to listen, to you. And sasa, by wake na kata haraka sana. Where are you?
Amen.
Before I move, I want to remind us mwisho wa kwamba sehemu ya rent inaleta shida kiasi. So naomba tuangalie hiyo sana. Neno la pili, kuna watu nilitumia ujumbe kusema kwamba tuambie wengine. Nani ambayo alipata ujumbe kutoka kwa hakuna. Yep. I've got another put a people down, my job. I could. That is your message, I quit. How to go a year, see? One has a few. Okay. So, in our Canada, your message, I quit. So, I don't know what you do, but the message in the nimeomba kwamba utembee na sadaka ya upendo leo. Utembee na sadaka ya upendo. Nishangae, simu inyonyesha kwamba message inaenda, lakini haikufika. Kwa hiyo machine. That's why I usually say technology sometimes fails us. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So, utakuta hiyo message imekuja baadaye. Mwai kuona kitu kama hicho. Yani umezi jimekaa tu kwa hewa. Alafu inakuja baadaye shamaliza the whole issue. So, nataka umletee kidogo sadaka ya upendo. Hata kama upate your message, nataka umletee sadaka ya upendo leo. So, naomba sadaka ya upendo leo. Niko. Nete kwa hapa. Hapa, sadaka ya upendo. Si mna nipe? Naona nipe? Nataka sadaka ya upendo. Na watu wametoa ya ndizi, Naona mjona na kukoti beti. Thank you. Hata mimi najipenda. Hata mimi najipenda. Thank you. Sadaka ya upendo, tafadhali. Na ukiwa na 10,000 leta. Thank you, thank you, Mr. Lucas. Wonderful. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you very much. God bless you. Another two?
Yes.
Oh, you go for technology. Metoa kitu kiasi. Shukuru Mungu. Mungu abariki sana. Na wazidishie neema. So Mentora 12:18. Si tuko matajiri. Nana najidharau hapa sasa. In a very short time tumetoa hiyo. Si kwa nimetayarisha. Kuni metoa. Na Mungu wabariki sana. Mungu very done today. Mungu wabariki sana.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe. Watu wanajiuliza, nasikia watu wakijiuliza na hiyo ni ya nini. Nani anauliza hiyo swali? Ndugu yetu Tom, mchungaji hapa alipoteza sister. Wangapi wanajua? Alipoteza dada yake. Niona tu hata tukitoa handkerchief ya kupanguza machozi itakuwa sawa. Handkerchief ni ishirini, sio? So tunashukuru Mungu. So let us pray for this offering. Lord, we thank you today. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your people who give, oh Jesus, cheerfully from their hearts. We glorify you and we give you praise today. Father, we ask you for your blessings upon their lives. Even today, Lord Jesus, as they walk and move and do whatever they do for their lives, Lord, we pray for a blessing. Thank you for the offerings and the tithes they are giving, Lord. We pray for a blessing into their lives now and forever. The Lord, they will experience your mighty move of the Holy Spirit in their lives, and they will glorify you day and night. We give you praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So, Brother Tom, prepare him. Recommend to. Now, another announcement. Today after ibada hii, tutaelekea Kariobangi South. Kariobangi South, hebi itakuruhusu kama wewe unaikaa karibu utakukimbia kwa nyumba maybe ile ilikuwa ingekuwa fair umetoa. Urudi mchukwe fair. Alafu uje, tuandamane, tuende Kariobangi South. Kule marehemu alikuwa naishi. So that we pray with the family and then we call it a day. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Nasikia ni Kariobangi South. Am I right? Yes. Kariobangi South. So, tutaenda pale as the church, and then we shall pray together with the family, and then we shall call it a day. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Another announcement. Today, tungeanza ile inaitwa makeup class. Kwa wale walikuwa najifunza evangelism, nilikuwa tuanze leo, but I called the teachers, nikawaambia tumepatwa na shughuli kidogo. Kwa hivyo wataanza kuja next Sunday. Jumapili wataanza kuja. Kwa hivyo if you missed any lesson during those lessons, please attend. Because they are coming for makeup classes, wamalize, ndio graduate. Mpewe certificates. Every participant will be given a certificate. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Nikilead the pack. Mimi ndio nitaongoza kupokea certificate.
Amen.
Those certificates are very important, may I tell you. Zinafika tu mahali zinakuwa very important.
Well, you may have a certificate inalala kwa nyumba unaona tu hii ilikuwa tu ya bure, haikusaidia. But a time comes when those certificates are needed. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Hebu anza business ya kwenda ngambo. America, nataka kwenda America, uone vile utaitishwa makaratasi. Amejiparua. Utaokota zote pale ulizificha. Alafu ulete. Alafu tukuandikia covering letter. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Uniulize, nimeandikia wengi covering letters. Kwa position ya mchungaji ni ajabu. You sent him so many abroad, lakini hao hujawahi enda. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Yeah, my signature imepitisha mtu pale kwa embassy. Akaenda, aenda ngamu. Nibio mchungaji nikifika huko sita kusahau. Kutoka siku alikanyaga huko hajawahi niandikia barua. Umenisaidia sana. Haki mchungaji umenisaidia sana. Nikifika huko sita kusahau. Enter the land of opportunities. Bwana asifiwe. No, atufi moyo. Don't think that nasikia vibaya. I feel good when my signature makes you pass. At a point. I feel so good. Najua kumbe signature yako pia ina uwezo. Sasa nitia. Bwana asifiwe. So we thank God for all that. So next Sunday we will be prepared for makeup classes. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So now I want us to share a word of God. Naona saa zimenipiga sana. So I don't know, nitakata vipande. Today I want us to say, Lord, I agree. Mwai kwambia hivyo Bwana Yesu. Lord, I agree. Mwai kusema hivyo kwa Mungu. Silence means unanisumbua. Bwana asifiwe. Have you ever stood before the Lord and said to him, Lord, I agree?
Yes.
So agree on what? That's the question now. Agree on what? So today we want to say, Lord, I agree. And I wish there was ample time so that tuende mbele za Bwana Yesu na tuseme, Lord, I agree. Mwambie, Lord, I agree. I agree. Tutaenda kwa kitabu cha Jeremiah. I don't know the right pronunciation. Is it Jeremiah? Or
Jeremiah?
Jeremiah is English, eh?
Yeah.
Alright. Now I teach English, so... there I was talking and I said, result! And somebody came to me and said, it is not result, it is result. I went to, I felt, no, this person is misleading me. Then I went and took a dictionary. Then from the dictionary, I discovered I was correct. Result. Result. Mother tongue, dialect. Natural idea. Still, I was talking somewhere and said, what are you doing? And everybody broke into laughter. He asked me, what have you said? Doing? And I said, yes, you know I'm a doing. We as do not have a D. Especially the dialect I come from. They don't have a D. They have a T. In their mother tongue. So it usually affects us. When has he feel?
Amen.
Has the Lord ever accepted you in your life? Has he ever accepted you? Do you feel the Lord has accepted you? What is the sign and symptom that the Lord has accepted you? Because the scripture, according to the scripture, he says, I accept those I accept and reject those I reject. He accepts those he accepts, he rejects those he rejects. You can be in the house of God, but God rejected you long time ago. You see, Saul was chosen by God to be king over Israel. But it came to a point where God rejected him. And when Samuel prayed over Saul, he prayed for Saul. When Samuel prayed for Saul, God spoke to Samuel and asked him a question. For how long shall you pray for Saul? Yet I rejected him. So there are times God rejects people. So when does God reject people?
When they reject him.
When they reject him. God rejects people when they reject him. Saul did a terrible sin before God. Mungu akasema, go and finish the Amalekites. Finish them. Do not leave anything. Kill everything. Human being and animal. Children and adults. Men and women. Kill everyone. But what did Saul do? He chose out of fat animals. Kachukua wengine akaweka kando. God said, kill. And then akachukua the king. King alikuwa anaitwa nani? Aga. Akamficha. So Samuel na anasikia mlio wa ng'ombe. See? Anasikia mlio wa ng'ombe. Sio kusikia literally, but in the spirit. Anasikia mlio wa ng'ombe. Then akauliza Saul, Saul, what is this that you did? And Saul anasema nilichukulia ng'ombe wanene. Saul akataka kuweka blame kwa watu. He was the king. And the commandment was given to him as the king. Kill everything. Hata kuku ilikuwa wapo. Hata kuku. But yeye aliamua kuweka kando. So God akaona this is disobedience of the highest order. When you disobey God, it's most likely a katana. You can reject it when you disobey. When it tells you to stop this and continue with it, unaendelea nayo, despite his telling you to stop it, when unaendelea nayo, he can reject you. Na ukae nyumbani kwake, fikiria kwamba niko na Mungu, kumbe alikukataa kitambo. Ajabu ni kwamba when he rejects you, he may not tell you I'm rejected. He may just withdraw and keep quiet. So you come to the house of God, and clear kwamba now, I and God are one. When in the really sense, you are pulling far apart. So it calls for searching. It calls for searching. I tell you, sometimes I go back to God and ask him, Lord, did you reject me? Then I hear him reaffirm. And then I continue. Then I do, yes, I'm still accepted. Yes, yes, I'm still accepted. I keep on calling. Someone may say, you doubt God. I don't doubt God. I know God can do. And I know beyond doubt that God is a miracle worker. And he can do anything that you think he can't do. He can do it. There is only one thing that is impossible for God to do. What is that?
To lie.
Mm-hmm. Cannot lie. Now listen. There is one thing God can never do. He can never go against His word. His word will stand forever, and He will never go against His word. So what He says, He must do. Unless you run away. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
When God calls you, He has a plan for your life. He has a plan. But the sad thing is, the children of God do not realize and do not identify the plan of God for their lives. And then they live carelessly. When they live carelessly, mixing with other people anyhow, and doing things other people do, not realizing that you have been called by God for a divine purpose. In Afrika, sir, God rejects you because you never followed His will for your life. I believe as you listen to me, you will be very careful that God will not reject you as long as you live. Bwana asifiwe. Mungu anaweza kukataa na uendelee kuishi raha. Maisha raha. Raha starehe. Nasema tu yes. Tunaenda mbinguni. Kumbe Mungu alikukataa kitambo. Nimewaambia the sad thing is when He rejects you, He doesn't tell you. He will just keep quiet. He may tell them, His servants, the prophets. Like He told Samuel, for how long will you pray for Saul? Yet I rejected him. So Saul knew God had rejected Saul. Samuel knew God had rejected Saul. Then God commanded him, go to the house of Jesse. I've chosen myself a king, a man after my soul. Then Ariadaka anointed David. Because he had rejected Saul. There is nowhere the scripture tells me Samuel went to Saul and told him God has rejected him. He never went to tell Saul God has rejected him. Though he knew, because God had spoken to him, he knew God had rejected Saul. And he knew that God had appointed another king to take over from Saul. But he never went to Saul to tell him, God has rejected you, and therefore he has appointed another king. Then he kept quiet. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. God will never walk away from you until you walk away from Him. He will never walk away from you. He will never reject you until you reject Him. That's His principles. When as if you were son. Are you there?
Yes.
Well, you in Ekuja along the way. I didn't plan to say that. So in Ekuja along the way. You know the heart of a prophet. Nisikia Lucas akisema wapendi wacha unabii. Mimi nakipenda sana. Bwana asifiwe. Nakipenda kabisa. Because you hear what God is saying. And He gives you words to utter to people. Na uzuri wa hicho kipawa ni kwamba Lucas shapokea, you speak the mind of God. Sema the mind of God. Then you sit back So it's up to the people to take it or reject it. So when you reject it, I just sit back to see the results. Because I cannot change your heart. You have decided the way you have decided. Then I sit back to see the results, what comes out. Ile matokeo. Matokeo wa machungu, hata nabii mwenye aliyetabiri usikia mchungu, but there is nothing I can do. I usually say a human being is a kingdom of his or her own, a kingdom. You know, you cannot go to Uganda and control the president of Uganda. It is the president of Uganda to control the matters of Uganda. Hata president wetu akatoka hapa hawezi control Uganda, because there is a president in Uganda. Now you are a kingdom of your own. And God gave you what you call a self-will. Self-will. Uwezo wa kuamua. Kwamba hivi ndivyo nataka niende. Una huo uwezo. Mungu alikupatia huo uwezo. Then if you are a kingdom of your own, you can only allow God into your life. You can only allow Him. He gave you that power, and that power, He never violates it. He has never violated. And that's why He does not force people to follow Him. He doesn't. He does not force. He only persuades you. He persuades you. He speaks to you persuasively, convincingly, convictingly to come to Him. But you can still say, to hell with you, God. Because you are just a kingdom. He will never force Himself into you until you allow Him into you. Bwana asifiwe. God can never force Himself into my family until I allow Him into my family. Therefore, I pray, God, I surrender my family unto you. Take control. Take control. So when I surrender to Him, He takes control of my family. Now He rules all. That's who God is. That is who God is. One as you. So, I urge you, brothers and sisters, let us open our doors wide open for God to come and take control. Bwana asifiwe. Aliambia wana Israeli msiguse miungu mingine. Aliambia wana Israeli hivyo, sivyo? Msiguse miungu. Sheria ya kwanza inasema, shall not have any other God. Sheria ya pili, you will not make yourself a graven image and worship it. Hamtajitengenezea sanamu. Hiyo sheria ya pili, sio? Sheria ya kwanza, msiwe na Mungu mwingine. Sheria ya pili ikasema, msijitengenezee sanamu. So ni sanamu ngapi tumejichongea? Tumejichongea sanamu, eh? I feel I'm speaking to somebody. Tumejichongea sanamu. Hayo sanamu itatumaliza. Please. Kama umejichongea sanamu, uende ufanye nini? Uivunje, vunje, weke motoni, iungue, na urudi kwa Mungu, ulie kilio, mwambie Bwana nisamehe, mwambie sitarudia. Otherwise, hiyo sanamu inaenda kumalika. Bwana asifiwe. Hiyo sanamu umejichongea, inaenda kumaliza. Bwana asifiwe. I don't know why I'm being derailed from my message. So, God loves you. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, God loves you.
God loves
you. Biblia inasema anakemea wale anao? Wale anaopenda. So ukikemewa mjue unafanya nini? Unapendwa. Ukisikia anakuambia you are getting away from me. He speaks and anafungua mdomo anasema wewe una anaanza kuonya. So anaanza kuonya, anaonya. Yeye anaonya tu. Natumia watumishi wake manabii kukuonya. Wanaonya. Na wewe unafuliza tu. Anasema hao ni upuzi. Hao watu wanapiga tu kelele. Unafuliza unaenda. Then it comes a period when the prophets keep quiet about your issues. They keep quiet about your issues. So akishanyamaza, now they're backing for God to take action. The prophets have warned you. They have told you what is coming to happen. They have warned you there is disaster awaiting for you. Kuna hatari iko mbele. Please change your course. They plead with you to change your course. But you refuse. Nakaza shingo. Inafika saa, the prophets keep quiet about your issues. Fuatilia story ya manabii katika Biblia. Fuatilia vile walikuwa natabiri. Walikuwa nafika mahali wanafunga mdomo. Sasa inakaa kana kwamba Mungu ameacha kuongea. Kumbe that's when now mambo mbaya iko njia. Alafu inapata watu ghafla pinfu. Unashtukia wamechukuliwa mateka. Unashtukia wamefungwa. Wamewekwa mateka. Wamekuwa watumishi wa maadui. That's what happens. And that's who a prophet is. He prophesies. Afya naenda zangu. Bwana asifiwe. A prophet cannot do anything to change you. He can only tell you what God is saying. But it's you to take action and do what? To change. That is within your power. To change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe. Let me read this chapter, this verse here. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 31. When God called you, he had a plan for you. It is up to you to agree to the plan that God has for your life. It's you to agree to that plan. And it's up to you to acknowledge the love God has for you, that even the Lord Jesus Christ had to come and die on the cross for the sake of your sins, because God had a plan. Bwana asifiwe. God had a plan for mankind. When he created Adam, he had a plan, a good plan. He planned good for Adam. I usually say God never planned for death. He never planned for death. Human beings were not to die. We were to live forever and ever. But now we die because sin came into the world. Did you know that if God would have allowed Adam to stay longer in the Garden of Eden after sinning, we would not be dying. We would be living forever with the sin, with the sickness, with the disease, the body. So na huo ugonjwa ungeweza kuua. So tungeishi milele na milele na dhambi. But because God had a good plan for mankind, he had to drive Adam out of the Garden of Eden. Because in the Garden of Eden, there was a tree of life. So Adam alikuwa hajakula tunda la mti wa uzima. And God drove him out of the garden. If God would have allowed him to stay longer in that garden, he would have eaten of the tree of life. And therefore, live forever with the sin, with all the suffering, And so because he had a good plan for you, it was good for you to die. So Akaona is good for this man now. I make plan B. So he made plan B. Plan B now was through death. Then he planned redemption. You to be redeemed. Tunaposoma maandiko tunaona. In the scripture, after Adam and Eve sinned, they discovered that they were naked. And when they discovered they were naked, what happened? They went into hiding. So they hid themselves from the presence of God. But God kept calling, Adam, Adam, where are you? Adam said, I had you walk in the garden and ran to hide myself because I was afraid, I'm naked. Then God knew that these people had eaten from the tree of knowledge of good and bad. Then Mungu alichinja mnyama. Hicho kitendo cha kuua, cha kuchinja, damu ikamwagika, hicho kitendo peke yake, it signified redemption. So the redemption was to take place, to redeem man back to the original plan that God had for you. That's why Jesus came to redeem you back to God's plan. One as you. Am I talking to people?
Yes.
So Jeremiah chapter 31 verse 3 nasema. That one verse 3. It nasema, the Lord has appeared of old to be saying, yes, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, with the loving kindness, I have drawn you. I have loved you with everlasting love. Therefore, with the loving kindness, I have drawn you. The love of God. Romans 8. God loved you with an everlasting love. And therefore, with the loving kindness, he has drawn you to himself. Amekuvuta kwake. Kwa upendo wake mkuu, amekuvuta kwake. Romans chapter 8 verse 35 inasema, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Now, Paul is asking, he experienced the love of Christ that drew him to Christ. That loving kindness that drew him to Christ. God loved him with everlasting love, and with the loving kindness drew him to himself. Now, he is asking, what then shall separate us from this love? What shall separate us from this love? Shall it be tribulation? Now, ukisoma the Message Bible, I was reading the Message Bible, nasema, translation yake iko tofauti kidogo, ikasema hivi, all these things cannot take us away from the love of Christ. That was a very nice translation, kasikia well. I think I need to read this thing further. Verse 36 says, as it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for slaughter. Yet all these things, Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. So Christ loved you. And because he loved you, through him, we are more than conquerors. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Through him, we are more than conquerors. Through him who loved us, Christ Jesus, all these things, distress, suffering, nakedness, hunger, and everything of that nature cannot draw us from the love of God, because he loved us. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Do you feel that love of Christ really in your life? Do you really feel it? Do you really feel that he loved you? That's the question. You know, we can be going to church, tunaabudu, we worship together, we sing together, but people do not feel the love of Christ in their lives. And that's why you cannot worship him the way you should, because you don't feel that love. May I tell you, people who have felt the love of Christ, hata wakifika kwa matatizo gani, they are not ready to quit, because they feel the love of Christ in their lives. They are not ready to quit. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. People who don't feel the love of Christ, may I tell you, they have a short span. Wakisimama ku praise, wanaanza kupiga miayo, because they don't feel that love in their lives. Neno la Mungu wanalisikia kama hadithi, because they don't feel that love of Christ. But anyone who feels the love of Christ in their lives, they will always be eager to hear from him. They'll always be eager to know more about him, because they know that Christ loves me. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
For those who have the love of Christ, all these tribulations, all these sufferings, all this persecution cannot take them away from the love of Christ. And through Christ who loved them, they are more than conquerors. Well, as if you will. The book of 1 John. 1 John chapter 3. First John chapter 3, verse 1. In a sense, behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. Therefore, the world does not know us, because it did not know him. What a manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. So when God loved you, he called you his child. Do you feel like you're a child of God? Bwana asifiwe. Do you feel like you're a child of God? Can you confidently stand before people and say, I'm a child of God? Or you will doubt. Because people doubt. You know, one day I stood before some people and said, Christians are foolish. But he said, why are you saying so? Christians are foolish. Aren't you a Christian? I said, I'm not a Christian. And they asked me, who are you? Then I'm a child of God. I'm not a Christian. And he said, why do you say Christians are foolish? Say Christians are foolish because they have the Bible but they don't read it. They call themselves Christians. They have the Bible, but they don't read it. They have the Bible, they read it. Some of them read, but they don't obey it. And in that Bible, we have all the answers to their questions. But they don't read the answers to their questions. Instead, they ask questions, the same questions from other people who mislead them later. Is it true? Sasa ni Jesus word. Ajabu ni kwamba, najua mimi nimewahi kukaa kwa slum. So najua mambo ya slum. Kwa hizo slums kuna vyumba. Vyumba. Kwa hiyo vyumba ni giza. Giza liko huko ndani. Unakuta mtu amevaa nadhifu, mtu mzuri sana. Mtu presentable. Naingia kwa hiyo vyumba. Anaketi. Wanamuita ameenda kwa nani? Kwa mwombaji. Si nikiuliza hapa tutapata watu ambao wamewahi kwenda kwa mwombaji. Tutapata?
Ndio.
Eh, tutapata. I hope hakuna yule bado anaenda huko. Diko. Hai, Mungu ndiye anajua. Nitakaponifunulia nitakwambia. Hiyo nyumba ina giza. Ukweli ni kwamba hiyo nyumba ina nini? Giza. Mtu anaingia huko na keti atabiriwe. Nimeleta mambo yangu ufanye nini? Uniangalie. So mtu anakuangalia maneno yako. And you are a Christian. Na huyo mtu anatumia nini? Ameweka hapo Biblia. Alafu wengine hutoa mshumaa wanawasha. Wengine hapo. Wengine anakuambia leta kitambaa cha rangi fulani, mshumaa rangi fulani. Hii mambo iko sana kwa sababu. Na utakuta mtu ambaye anafanya hiyo kazi. Na yeye pia kwa mfano ni mtu ana mali kwa mfano. Au amejenga nyumba ya mawe. Amechukua tuka kibanda kakufanyia hiyo kazi, amejenga kando kakibanda kama bati. Amejenga kando. So wewe unaenda unaangaliwa mambo yako kwa hako kakibanda kachafwa. And you have the Bible. It has all the answers. Bwana asifiwe. So are you wise? That's the question now. God biguni, Mungu biguni anasema anauliza, how foolish are my children? Yesu akisimama pale mbinguni kwa mkono wa kuume wa Baba, anaangalia unatangatanga, unamwacha, unatangatanga. Anasema, and I died for that person. So you should wake up as a child of God. You should wake up. God loved you to a point that he called you his child. So why do you weep? Kwa nini unayumbayumba? Unatakataka. He loved you and called you his child. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I want to say this. Nikimalizia. I want you to understand. And from today, I want you to understand. Chapter 4 verse 10 inasema, in this is love that we, in this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the propitiation for our sins. You never loved him, but he loved you. And because he loved you, he sent his son to be a sacrifice for your sins. A sacrifice for your sins. Na Biblia inasema tusimrudishe msalabani mara ya pili. Bwana asifiwe. Tusimrudishe nani msalabani?
Yes.
Yes. tuzimrudishe msalabani mara ya pili. By being foolish, by doing foolish things, let us not take him back to the cross. For he loved you and cares for you. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
From today, I want you to know that God loved you from the beginning, even before you knew him. He loved you. Hata wakati ulikuwa umepotelea dhambi, he loved you and cared for you. And that's why, by his love, he drew you close to him. By his love, he sent Christ to die for you, to take your place, so that you may be called his child. So, from the day he died for you, you became his child. And as his child, mtoto akiwa na shida, anakimbilia nani? Mzazi. Aende kwa wazazi wengine huko nje. Anakimbilia mzazi, namwambia mzazi nina shida hii na shida hii. God is not like us human parents. Baba atakwambia I don't have, sina uwezo. God is an everlasting father. He will provide all your needs. Well, has it been?
Amen.
Naomba tusimame. He provides all your needs according to his riches and glory. Because he called you his child. So you should not wonder about. Do not wonder about. Because he cares for you. So as we say, as we sing this song, I want you to just lift your voice unto him. I want you to tell him these words. Please get these words clear. I want you to tell God these words. Lord, I agree that you have to tell him, Lord, I agree that you have loved me and that I'm the very person for whom Christ died. These are words you are going to tell the Lord. Lord, I agree that you loved me and that I'm the very person for whom Christ died. Tell him I acknowledge that you have loved me with an everlasting love and that with your loving kindness, you are continually drawing me to you. Those words you tell Christ in your prayer. Chakutu maiki
Milaya miyakesu Inawe mawakutoja Namfisa Mamba ni salama.
kwake Yesu nasimama.
Ndiye mwamba ni salama. Ndiye mwamba ni salama. Ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Kwake Yesu nasimama.
Ndiye mwamba ni salama. Ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Let's lift up your voice and give the tell you, Lord, I agree. Lord, I agree to your plan. Father, Rakobo Singh, Lord, I agree to your plan, Lord Kingdom God. Glad you had my life, Lord Jesus. Father, I am grateful to sit in your passion. I give you, Lord, to the man for a good time. That's what I'm trying to do, sit in your Father, I have question. I have claimed that I am the very pastor. Holy Christ died for the pastor to be blessed. That you prove me with your everlasting love, Lord Jesus. That you are continuing growing me, Lord, by your loving kindness. I give that question. I have question. God, I have question. I give with you, Lord Jesus Christ, and I give you praise, Lord. I give you praise, Lord Jesus, for the love that you've imparted into my life, Lord Jesus. The loving kindness, Lord Jesus, that you've imparted into my life. Lord Jesus, I give you praise, Lord. I give you praise, Lord Jesus, because you loved me with an everlasting love. You, Lord Christian, with your loving kindness, Lord, you drew me closer to you. They became the child of God. Lord, I give you praise. They worship you, dear Father. Acknowledge your precious name. Acknowledge your great name, Lord Jesus. Because of your loving kindness, Lord, dear Father. May your name be glorified. May your name be honored. The last of us are worshiping. May your name be lifted up on high, Lord Jesus. May you, Lord Jesus, lift up that of us. May you bless us, Lord Jesus Christ. Because you are the King of Kings, and you are the Lord of Lords. You are the Savior, the Healer, the Deliverer, the mighty God who speaks in our lives, Lord. We worship you and we give you praise today, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, for every great thing that you do. We worship your precious name, Lord Jesus. We exalt you and extol you. And bless you, mighty God of heaven, because you are born in our lives. We love you, mighty God of heaven. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. We bless you, mighty God, and that of you. I bless you, King of Kings. Lord, we give you praise and glory today. You speak to us in a way that, Lord, Father, you call us back to you, that you may glorify your great name. Lord Jesus, we give you praise, we honor you. Thank you for the people who are standing here today. We are praying that, Lord Jesus, your spirit shall come upon your people and fill them and give them the confidence that they are children of God. Lord, I pray that the Spirit of God will witness unto their hearts that God loved them with an everlasting love. And with your loving kindness, you've drawn us to you. Lord, you continually draw us to you. Lord, we give you praise and glory. We pray that your Spirit will speak to us and bear witness with our hearts that, Lord, you loved us with an everlasting love. And with your loving kindness, you've drawn us close to you. Yes. And you've called us your children. Yes. Lord Jesus Christ, God, speak unto your people now, Lord Jesus. Speak unto their hearts. I pray by your Holy Spirit, speak unto their hearts, Lord. That Lord Jesus Christ, God, they will witness, they will speak of your wonders. They'll feel the love of God encompassing them wherever they go, wherever they are. Lord Jesus, I pray that, Lord Jesus, they will feel the love of God that encompasses them, that embraces them, that, Lord Jesus Christ, they will glorify you, and they'll worship you every day because you are the King in their lives. We give you praise and glory, oh dear Father. We acknowledge your precious name. Father, touch your people. Bow for fellowship. Whoever is hurting in any way, we command healing in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We command healing in their lives now, in the name of Jesus. Whoever is sick in their bodies, Lord, we pray today that they be healed in the name of Jesus. We command sickness to leave their bodies now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
And we pray that, Father, in the name of Jesus, you will touch their lives, Lord, and they'll give praise and glory unto you, because you are mighty and glorious. Because, Father, you work wonders. You work miracles in the lives of your people. We ask you for financial miracles in the lives of your people today. We command financial miracles. We are calling money to come to our hands, Lord. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray for your favor. Yes. Favor to attract money. Yes. Favor to attract finances. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us attract finances to our life. Let us attract money. In the name of Jesus Christ, Ecclesia. Let it come to pass, Lord Jesus, that money will come to us. Father, money will come to us. It will come to us in the name of Jesus. We command it to come in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We command it to come in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we shall give you praise and glory now and forever, because you are God who touches your people. Father, fill us with your presence. Fill us with your glory. As you walk on the face of the earth, Lord, we want to feel your presence wherever we go, that your name will be glorified. We thank you and we bless you. We acknowledge you, Lord Jesus. We give you glory. Father, as we part from here, Lord, we pray, guide us in all paths of righteousness. Lord, let us follow you every day, that your name will be glorified. We thank you and we bless you. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God
and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you. Maybe